I want you to take a moment and consider the greatest sports victory you ever witnessed. Who was the biggest underdog who defeated the huge favorite? And then think about the greatest sports collapse. Maybe the team that snatched defeat out of the jaws of victory. As we gather together Sunday at 8 a.m. in the sanctuary and 10:30 a.m. outside, continuing to live stream as well as broadcast over WPGM radio, we'll be thinking about this idea of victory from 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 19 through 22. This follows up our message from last Sunday, where we looked at the idea that freedom isn't free. And in Jesus Christ, we have the greatest sacrifice. Christ suffered once for sins. We have the greatest substitute, the righteous one for the unrighteous ones. The greatest purpose to bring you to God. The greatest victory, put to death in the body, but made alive in the spirit. As we think about that freedom through Jesus Christ, we're reminded that it comes because of the victory of Christ over sin and death. And so in verses 19 through 22 of 1 Peter chapter 3, we'll be looking at these ideas that victory is proclaimed, victory is pictured, victory is provided, and victory is permanent through the Lord Jesus Christ. Are you and I experiencing victory in this life? Doesn't mean we'll have an easy life, but it means that we don't just survive, we thrive because of our walk with the Lord Jesus Christ. And it begins by having a personal relationship with Him, by admitting our sin, repenting, turning from it, and seeking forgiveness available only through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, giving our life to Him. And He changes everything. So victory, what is victory? And what does victory look like in the life of the believer? Have a blessed day as you look at the Word of God and seek its application for your life, that you and I would never be the same.